Hello everyone, my name is John. Today, I will tell you how to set up uploading new rows from Google Sheets to the system you need via webhook. This is necessary in order to automatically transfer new lines from Google Sheets to other systems. For example, you can send this data via webhook to the system you need, conveniently store, process and interact with it in every possible way in the future. Now let's move on to the setup. First, you need to create a new connection. Next, you need to select the Google Sheets data source system. Now you need to select an action. Get rows new. At this stage, you need to connect your Google Sheets account to the ApiX-Drive system. In this window, you must specify the username and password of your personal Google account. At this stage, be sure to check all the checkboxes for access. When the connected login is displayed in the list, select it. Then you need to specify the file and sheet from which the data will be uploaded. In the field Start Data Loading with Row Number, you must specify the row number from which you want to start uploading data. For example, if you have 1000 rows in the table, and you do not want to transfer all these rows, you need to specify the number 999 in order to start downloading from the last one. I have 2 rows in my table, so I will specify 2. Now you can set up a data filter. In this case, there is no need for this, so just click Continue. At this stage, you see the data from the line that you specified in the settings. If everything suits you, click Next. On this setting of the Google Sheets data source has been successfully completed, now you need to move on to setting up data reception. Select Webhook as the data receiving system. Next, you need to select an action. Send data. At this stage, you need to connect your system via webhook to the ApiX-Drive system. Webhook is a universal way to transfer data. In order to connect, in this window you must specify the URL for sending data, that is, the link to which ApiX-Drive will send data from Google Sheets. In order to get this link, you need to check with the support of the system to which you want to transfer data, whether it is possible to receive data via webhook, and how exactly this can be configured. For example, we will connect the Corizoid system via webhook. In order to do this, we need to go to this system and create a new process. After the process is created, click Start. In the window that appears, click Copy webhook via JSON. Now go to the ApiX-Drive system and paste the copied webhook. How exactly to get a link to a webhook can be clarified in the support of the system to which you will send data. When the connected login is displayed in the list, select it. At this stage, we need to choose the type of data sending. In this case, I choose PostJSON. Which type of data sending is suitable for your system, you can also check with its support. Next, you need to create parameters that consist of the name of the variable and the value. In the name field, you need to write the name of the variable. What it should be, you can also check in the support of the system to which you want to transfer data via webhook. I will use the name of the variables that are used in the Corizoid system. In the value field, you need to select the value that corresponds to this variable from the drop-down list. In order for another set of parameters to appear, click Add. When all the necessary names and values are filled, click Continue. At this stage, you see an example of data that will be sent to the system you need via webhook. If something does not suit you, click Edit and go back a step. In order to check the correctness of the settings, click Send Test Data to Webhook. After successful sending, go to the system to which you transferred data via Webhook and check the result. If everything suits you, return to the ApiX-Drive system and continue setting up. This completes the configuration of receiving Webhook data successfully. Now you need to enable auto-update and select the communication interval, for example, once every 5 minutes. That's all. I wish you successful integration settings and good luck.